Hey everybody, Rich with Mustang Connection, and I have a special treat today. Let's just say I am with a collector in a special location, and this could quite possibly be the ultimate Ford Mustang collection, Ford High Performance collection. I'm going to walk around and share this with you, and it's so impressive. And the gentleman that owns it is just a super cool guy. In fact, down the line you may see more, because the Super Cobra Jet Torino has been moved into his hands, and he does arguably some of the world's best restorations on these products. They are absolutely museum quality. So let me walk you around. Hope you enjoy it. Thanks everybody for watching. See y'all soon. I'm just gonna do a quick walkthrough. Let's just suffice it to say these are all gonna be cars that are restored to the highest levels, and they are just works of art. So it's a little busy in here right now. He's kind of moving some things around. I don't want to get too close to the cars with the camera. So I'll, again, just gonna walk quickly around, give you the scoop. Just take a look at the memorabilia. I mean, we could start there. He's essentially recreated Ford dealerships. All the unique and hard to find items are in here. And just, it's so neat to be able to experience this. It's really like being in a Ford museum in a Time Warp. And as everyone knows on the channel, I'm a real avid lover, collector, hobbyist. And this is the kind of stuff that's just such a treat to see in person. He's gracious enough to let me walk around. So just look at all the neat stuff. I mean, even Autolite battery tray. He's got all his toy collection in here. I'm not even gonna walk back in this section. It's really cool Bronco, first gen. This is all original, by the way. This one hasn't even been repainted. It's just as it sits. Okay, so let's go through. Starting with the new Ford GT, or not new now, but the 06 Ford GT black silver car. Not a wrapper car, but very low miles. This is a Cobra Jet, a Ranchero GT in Calypso Coral with this really cool plaid interior. This happens to be a 70. The Mighty Boss 429 in Royal Maroon. This car is spectacular. Hopefully someday I'll get a ride in that. Here's a Cobra 2 Mustang. He's got a little Pinot runabout over there, kind of the odd man out, but I think it's because it's got low miles on. It's all original. I believe this Bronco, if not restored, is all original as well. This has the cool green houndstooth interior in it. There's that little silver King Cobra. Mustang 2. I'm not gonna walk through this way, it's a little tight right now, but this, the Boss 429 is one of the nicest in existence. This is a super rare 1969 Shelby GT500 convertible with in white, and that's called Gulfstream Aqua. And I'll walk over in that direction and give you another shot. Kind of cool, he's got all the collectibles you can possibly think of that are related to the era. Just super cool stuff. I kind of swinging back around, and here's a Laguna Seca modern Boss 302. And then a 79 Pace car, Fox body. This is a wrapper car. This has little to no miles on it. He has all the memorabilia that goes with it. I believe he's even got a stick shift. He has a stick shift car, pretty rare four-speed car. This one he just finished. This is a 67 GT390 car. This will give you an indication of the level. All the engine compartments look like this. Little to no reproduction parts, right down to the finest detail. The fit, the finish, again, none finer you'll see anywhere. Just spectacular. Here's a 68 428 Cobra Jet car. This car I have filmed at Knott's Berry Farm before. absolutely world class. 67 GT500 Night Mist Blue, I believe it is. Just, you know, what can you say? Spectacular car. This is also a 4-speed. Pretty neat down here, this little electric car. Of course, you got the Mighty Boss 302. This car is also stick shift. Yes, this is also a 4-speed. The 428 Cobra Jet car is a 4-speed. What's unique on the 68, you see that? They came out with the Cobra Jet Scoop. In 68, they don't have the turn indicators like they do in 69 and 70 on the non-Ram Air cars. And just kind of taking a look at all the neat stuff in here too. Look at all the banners, working signs. I could spend hours in here. I don't want to hold them up though, so I'm going to kind of just walk through. It's funny, my first car, I had a Mach 1. I had that little key fob right there. I still remember buying it at the Ford dealership, nonetheless. And here's the Boss 302. This is a world-class restoration on this vehicle. Twister Special Cobra Jet car, very rare, in matching color. I didn't even mention he's got a Pantera over there. I mean, look at that. This is also a 4-speed car. Beautifully restored. Just spectacular. '71 Boss 351 in black and argent. Just awesome ride. These are also stick only on these. Beautiful car. And just more of the awesomeness of the collection. They've recreated the Ford Performance Corner over here. He's cleaning up a little bit, so I'm just gonna make it quick, but what the Ford Performance Corner, all these bits from 1969-70 era. And you can see this Ford Performance Corner stand. You got a Christmas tree in here for staging. And here's that beautiful Gulfstream Aqua 1969 Shelby GT500. Also a stick shift. But there you go, just a spectacular collection of the some of the finest Mustangs and Ford performance cars and parts and neat stuff you're ever gonna see. Hey guys, so check this out. Of course, the Ultimate Collector has this really neat dealer book that showed all the different interior colors and stuff. So when you're selling a customer, you could say, okay, which color do you want to order and what type of interior and trim. But anyway, I just wanted to show you that this is not a made-up color. This really is new line. There it is. And it does look yellow, but trust me, it's not. This actually has a lot of green in it. And the only way you can really see it is when something green is next to it, because the interior has a lot of green components. But if you look here, you can see it's more green than yellow. So here's the yellow, I'm looking at it next to it. You can really see the green. Kind of trippy, huh? Anyway, thought I'd share that with you. So I hope you enjoyed that, and don't drool too much. This is a pretty spectacular collection. I could spend hours and hours here, but hey, thanks everybody for watching. See y'all soon.